So back around last Christmas, I released my book, The Ancestral Indigenous Diet, which is my summary of my 7 years of nutritional research and understanding. And I hope you guys didn't think I would make you wait this long for an audiobook. Amazon has been going back and forth for 6 months with nonsense after nonsense requirements. I honestly thought Amazon just wasn't gonna let me on their platform. Better late than never, I guess. Ancestral to point out that it's what we as humans have consumed in our dietary past, and indigenous referring to our variable native environments that we did observe dietary consistencies throughout. The original subtitle, Achieving Native Health in a Modern World, is about identifying what problems occur when we stray from our native diets, especially pollutants and chemicals in our food and water, bombardment from non-native electric frequencies, especially a lack of sun exposure, and of course we can't forget, nutrients from animal-based foods. A Whole Foods meat-based carnivore diet tackles that. It's sort of a stab at the Whole Foods plant-based nonsense, but what it really does is put the focus on meat. The majority of the nutrients our bodies require come from animal-based foods, whereas plant foods serve a lesser purpose of energy, sometimes minerals here and there. We can't discount that both were included in our past diets, but since modern diets are swayed heavily towards plant foods, I feel inclined to sway people back in the other direction of meat. Most importantly though, the message is food quality. I'm happy to say that my book has been the first step for many in coming across unbiased dietary concepts. People spend their whole lives bouncing from diet to diet, trying to fix their health issues, without realizing the two most important aspects. One, the positives, the nutrients we need to build our bodies, and two, the negatives, removing the chemicals and pollutants from our bodies. Unfortunately, people don't make a lot of money from telling you the truth. All this takes is the willingness to unlearn conventional wisdom, prioritize essential nutrients, and embrace some of our ancestral history. This book will be your guide, and the results will be a new lifestyle that puts natural health above everything else. You guys will learn everything I have, including the importance of nutrients, the downsides of anti-nutrients that are contained in certain plant foods, how much of these nutrients you specifically need, what foods to get them from, where to source these foods, as well as how to prepare them. I'm going to leave you guys with a few minutes of the first chapter. You can purchase the book or audiobook in the Amazon link down below. And I think I'll do a raffle for all of you guys that purchase the audiobook this weekend. I'll be giving some of you a free code that you can share with someone else to give them a free copy of the audiobook. So thank you guys for joining me today. If you'd like to chat later, we're going to be doing a vegan critique live stream on the channel Frank Tufano. I'll link that down below as well. You guys enjoy the rest of your night.
I forgot to show you guys the best part of my outfit, my caveman walnut strands.
Chapter 1, Rediscovering Our Ancestral Indigenous Diet. Have you ever seen a wolf wear glasses? Are gorillas making kale shakes in the jungle? Are sharks wearing braces? Humans are animals. We evolved into our current physical form tens of thousands of years ago before spreading out across the globe. We look, live, and eat differently depending on the specific location where we settled. Every aspect of human physical development has been guided by these factors over hundreds, even thousands of generations. Not only was our development dictated by these factors, but many of the problems of modern civilization are a result of us having abandoned this environment. The largest change in recent generations has been to our diet. Although other critical elements of health, water, exercise, sun exposure, and sleep, also undergoing major shifts. The human diet, all across the planet, has always been composed of high-quality animal and plant foods that vary by region. According to some historical accounts, indigenous people didn't suffer from the modern degenerative diseases that are so common today, let alone dietary conditions like type 2 diabetes. My belief is that this was primarily due to what they ate,
Their water was also free of modern contaminants, both physical and chemical, and they used to get much more sun exposure while staying active throughout the entire day. Now, after spending most of our waking hours inside, we try to make up for hours and hours of sedentary activity with a small window of exercise. Then we sleep poorly, surrounded by blue light from electronic screens, before waking up to an alarm clock in the middle of our sleep cycle. There is no going back to the past. Few would want to, but with a little bit of effort and a change to our mindset, we can take some steps to rediscover our ancestral health. There is direct action that you can take right now, primarily by adding high-quality animal foods to your diet, to begin repairing the damage caused by modern eating and lifestyle choices. Only one thing is stopping us: what we've been told all our lives. The ancestral indigenous diet versus the paleo diet. Some people familiar with diet trends may think they have heard this before. Isn't this the paleo diet? Certain elements of my approach to nutrition do line up with the paleo diet, and some of the ancestral-based concepts are similar. But no, my philosophy is quite different. At its core, the paleo diet focuses more on what foods you can't eat as opposed to what foods you should eat. Many civilizations have consumed grains that didn't exist in the days of cavemen, for example, and lived in excellent health nevertheless. Dismissing this knowledge just to devoutly follow the idea that we must eat exactly like our ancestors before the agricultural revolution can begin to border on religious. Instead, we need to dig deeper and begin to understand which foods are bad for us and which are absolutely critical. Recognizing which foods are most important from a nutrient, vitamin, and mineral standpoint is largely absent in most paleo diet descriptions. Paleo, in many ways, is about restriction. My ancestral indigenous diet, above all else, is about prioritizing the foods that you must consume. For me, nutrient density is the basis of everything. We start by understanding which nutrients are the most essential to health and focus all of our attention on consuming them. Then, at the same time, we cut out everything that doesn't serve a clear purpose. Yes, it does turn out that most of the best foods to consume are similar to what cavemen survived off of, but the argument for why we should eat them now in the 21st century is based much more in nutritional science, not dogma and modern marketing spin. Even more importantly, the paleo diet has been largely corrupted by people who start making brownies with 30 different paleo ingredients, not to mention the corporate and special interest groups working to make sure people don't understand the importance of food quality, selling you low-quality products under the guise of the paleo diet. I'm not bashing the paleo diet from afar. I have tried it and understand why paleo has appealed to so many people. The version I followed involved me eating 5 pounds of sweet potatoes per day in an attempt to fix my lack of energy. More carbs equals more energy, or so I thought.